Hey guys, it's Megan. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a wedding dress shopping tips, tricks, and my personal experience. So let's just go ahead and get started. So I got engaged in July of 2017. It is now January 2018. I actually did say yes to my dress a few weeks ago on the 14th, so I just thought I would share with you guys my personal experience and things that I learned along the way that I hope can help you in your experience in finding your dress. So the first thing that I'm going to say is don't compare yourself to anyone else. Don't compare your experience or your how many times you go or anything like that to anyone else. For example, I went wedding dress shopping 6 times, which is a lot more than what is considered normal, I would definitely say. I'm actually in a couple of bride to bride groups on Facebook, and I asked in that group, I said, you know, like, hey, how many times did you guys go to find your dress and that kind of thing? And most people, I think, said like 1 to 3 times. And at that point, I think I had already gone like 3 or 4 times, and I hadn't, you know, found anything that I was super in love with. So I was like, oh my gosh. I mean, I really liked a few things, but just nothing had really like popped out at me just yet. But it's okay to go more than once, and it's okay to only go once. Like, just don't feel like you have to do it a certain way or go a certain amount of times or do what someone else did or anything like that. I mean, you can definitely find your dream dress the first time. Like, I actually did commit to a dress, put a down payment on it the very first time I went. I ended up canceling that down payment and not finding my real dream dress until maybe, like, 3 or 4 appointments later or something like that. So definitely keep in mind that you don't have to commit right away. You will obviously have to make a commitment at some point. So go with the idea that you can commit and that you might commit, but don't feel like you have to at that certain point in time. It's okay to say, okay, you know what? I love this dress, but I need to take a step back and I need to think about it, if that makes sense. Next is to set a budget. I know that this is like beating a dead horse, but this is really important, especially now that I've actually gone shopping, like watching Saya say a dress and they're like, oh, set a budget. I was like, yeah, whatever. But for real, set a budget. Because if you try on a dress that's over your budget or over your price point, there's a very good chance that you're going to fall in love with it. And then if you physically can't afford that, you're going to be on your wedding day thinking about that other dress, and that's just like, that's not how you want to feel. Like, you want to feel your best, you want to look your best, you want to feel the most confident and the most beautiful that you have ever felt, because that is your day and that's how you get to feel. And so it's so important to make sure that you can handle that expense, if that makes sense. So it's also important to, when you go shopping, think about alterations. Think when you're thinking about your budget. Think about like getting a bustle, because those are things that you're going to need to do. They order your dress a bigger size than what you are so that they can tailor it to fit your body exactly. So with that being said, when you're thinking of a budget, definitely find out, you know, or at least like give yourself a few $100 or so, you know, wiggle room, because you are going to need that for those alterations. And even when you're at the bridal salon, feel free to ask them, you know, how much is this going to cost me to do alterations? How much is it going to cost to hem this? How much is it going to cost to do a bustle? Because you'd be surprised. Like, there was a dress that I tried on. It was the dress that I had first said that I yes to, and then I ended up canceling it. But it had like 7 different layers. So I think it was like $300, or it was like $150 or $300, I don't remember. But it was a lot of money just to bustle it. Like, that was it, just to bustle it, because of the different layers and everything. So definitely make sure that you keep things like that in mind when you're going. Next is to know what you like and what you don't like. But with that, don't, like, you can definitely shop online ahead of time, or like look at things, or know an idea of what you like and what you don't like. But I would definitely say, if you're anything like me, don't necessarily find specific dresses that you want to try on at the salon, because for me personally, I'm going to be comparing myself to that model, and then I'm not really going to feel, you know, maybe as beautiful in it as if I hadn't ever seen anyone else in that dress. Like, personally, I just want to know what it looks like on me, because I'm the one wearing it and I want to feel the most confident and the most beautiful that I can on my wedding day. So I don't really want to see what a model looks like in this dress, because clearly I am not a model, so I'm not going to look the same way in that dress as she does. So definitely keep that in mind so that you can just be as confident as you can. But, so it's definitely important to know what you like and what you don't like. But definitely still keep an open mind, because I can say from experience, the dress that I try, that I said yes to, is so far from what I, well, maybe not so far, but it's definitely not exactly what I originally was looking for in certain ways. Like, it wasn't something that I necessarily would have gone with the very first time I went. Like, it had aspects of what I was looking for originally, but it had certain elements to it that I only discovered that I loved after several different appointments of trying on different things. So definitely keep that in mind to know what you like, know what you absolutely despise or what you don't like, but definitely keep an open mind and try on different silhouettes to fit your body, because you may be surprised. Like, I was not really looking for like a mermaid style or a trumpet or anything like that, or a fit and flare, but I did try on quite a few and I ended up really liking them. I didn't go with one because I really wanted a ball gown, because I mean, when else can you wear a ball gown in your whole life except on your wedding day? But you'd be surprised about how your mind can change and your perceptions can change. So definitely keep an open mind and you could be very surprised. The bridal consultants are there to do their job. They know what looks good on different body types, and definitely trust their advice and see what they can come up with. So definitely keep an open mind. That's very important. Hold on, I'm looking at my notes. Yes, I have notes. Next is to keep your theme in mind. If you have a theme or a time of year or anything like that, I would definitely say keep that in mind. But at the same time, don't feel like you need to stick with that particular certain thing. Like, if you are having a rustic barn wedding and you don't want, you know, a lace country chic dress or whatever, and you want like this super glam, completely bedazzled from head to toe dress, like, go for it. Why not? If it fits your theme, awesome. If not, do you love it? If yes, then wear it. It's your day. You can do whatever you want. That's the great thing about it. Like, I don't know where we're even getting married, but I know that I am going to feel beautiful in my dress, and I don't care where we're getting married. Well, I kind of care, but you know what I mean. So it's important to keep that in mind so that can maybe help you figure out what you're looking for, but at the same time, don't necessarily limit yourself to that if there's something that you know that you love that may not necessarily fit in the box of what your theme is. So definitely keep that in mind. Group size. Now this is a tricky one. So I'll explain to you what I did. A lot of people say bring a small group, and I can definitely see why, and I kind of agree with that, because personally for me, I'm someone that doesn't really stand up for myself ever. So if, like, having a huge entourage every time that I went dress shopping would have just completely overwhelmed me, and I probably would have broken down and just started crying in the dressing room. So if you're someone who has trouble voicing your opinions, or you have trouble sticking up for yourself, or, you know, if you're anything like me, basically, it's okay to keep a much smaller group. What I did was, every single time I went dress shopping, except for the very last time, I had no more than two people. Once I had actually found my dress, chosen my dress, knew that it was my dress, I didn't officially say yes, I went and had a one last appointment at the place that I found my dress. And I invited, like, everybody. I think I had maybe 13 people there, which was a lot, because I already knew which dress it was. So I tried on some other dresses for fun and, you know, just to, because I was so confident in my choice, you know, just so that everybody could really get the experience, so that they didn't all come to the dress place, the boutique or whatever, just for me to try on the one dress. So just to give everybody the full experience, and it was a really fun time. And then I said yes in front of everybody. So, you know, my close friends, my grandma, my sisters, my aunt, my cousin, my fiance's mom. So I think that I kind of liked doing it that way, because then I wasn't worried about having all these opinions when I really was trying to make up my mind. Like, everyone knew that I had already chosen the dress, but we still had fun looking at other dresses. So I think that's definitely something to keep in mind if you do have a lot of people like me that you want to be a part of the process, but you don't want to be overwhelmed by so many opinions at once. So definitely, you know, maybe go more than once, take more people, you know, take different people to different places, and it can be really fun because you can definitely experience different things, different dresses, and learn more about yourself and your style and your body and what you like, while being able to have different opinions along the way. So that's something that I would really recommend if you do have a lot of people, because if you do have, like, your entourage, if they have a lot of loud voices and opinions that you think will really kind of, cover your own voice, cover your own voice, then definitely take that into account. But I mean, if you know your entourage and you know that they're not like that and they'll be really supportive but still be truthful with you and give their honest opinion without being too harsh, then I would say, yeah, do it. You know, take 25 people. You do you, girl. So just, you know, keep that in mind. Know your entourage and know how you are and what, you know, maybe situation that you would respond in the best way, if that makes sense. Next is heels, makeup, and hair. So for my very last appointment, I made sure that I already had my heels because heels are a big thing, because what they told me at that salon was that they could measure me from chest to the floor with my shoes on, and they could order that dress in that length so I wouldn't have to get it hemmed, because hemming is really expensive. So it turns out that the heels that I found, I don't even need to have my dress hemmed. So I'm saving so much money right there. So definitely, if you know the dress that you're going to have before you say yes, like, definitely take your shoes or take a heel, like, you know exactly how tall you want your heel to be, that kind of thing, because that can really end up saving you some money in the long run. And I'll also have my shoes linked down below so you guys can see them. I only got them for like $18 on sale, so definitely saved some money there as well. Makeup and hair. So for my very last appointment, I did because I knew what my dress looked like, I did like a silver, eye look and that kind of thing because I knew. But do your makeup and your hair when you go, because you are going to be all done up. If you have an idea of the makeup or hair that you're going to want or have on your wedding day, definitely do that, because you want to, you know, kind of get the full picture. You want to know what you're going to look like. You want to feel confident and beautiful when you're going to try those dresses on, because you want to feel confident and beautiful on your wedding day. So, heck yeah, why not? I mean, it's important to feel confident when you're trying those dresses on so that you can really know which one you love the most, because I don't know what I was gonna say but anyway, moving on. Give yourself enough time to get your dress. I'm not getting married until like fall or winter of next year, so 2019, so I have plenty of time to get my dress, because it does take, for me personally, I'm doing like a payment plan on my dress, so they don't order it until you have half of the payment, like, taken. So until you've paid for half of it, they won't order it. So once I pay for half of it, then they'll order my dress. Then I have to wait for the dress to come in, and then you have to get fittings, you have to get it altered to fit you, and da da da, all this stuff. So make sure that you give yourself plenty of time. I think that they, the shortest amount of time they recommend is like 9 months. So definitely give yourself more than enough time to get your dress ordered, get it fit so that you're ready to go. And if you're thinking that you're going to be losing weight, they can always take your dress down 2 sizes. So definitely just try on what fits your body now when you are going to try on dresses. And then, you know, just keep in mind or let them know that you're planning on losing weight. And just, they can alter the dress to fit your body. Don't feel like you have to alter your body to fit in the dress, because you can definitely find something that you're going to look beautiful in no matter how big or small or whatever you are. So, like, don't worry about that. Just look for what you, like, takes your breath away. Like, honestly, when I tried my dress on, I literally gasped because it literally took my breath away. It's so beautiful. So just don't worry about anything. Don't worry about the size, because dress sizing is weird. Like, they ordered me, I think, a 12, and I wear, like, a size, like, 8 pants or something like that. So just don't worry about it. No one's gonna know how big your dress is. They're just gonna know how bomb you look on your wedding day. So keep that in mind. Trunk show. This is a good idea. The only reason I decided now to get my dress, because I was going to wait longer, is because the dress that I knew that I wanted, they were having a trunk show for that designer. I ended up getting $100 off of my dress because it was the trunk show. Because basically a trunk show is they have the dresses from that particular designer on sale, and then they're also bringing in new dresses from that designer that they wouldn't normally have in the store. So definitely keep your eyes peeled for trunk shows, because you could be really pleasantly surprised about what you might find that they might not normally have in the salon, as well as you're also going to save some money as well. I actually saved, like I said, I saved $100 on my dress, and I ended up getting a veil and the skirt to fill, like, the underskirt to go under my dress and fill it out. And I ended up basically getting the underskirt for free, because then they also said if you had over $200 in accessories, you would get $100 off. So I even was able to save money on that as well. And I ended up getting two free gifts. So the place that I went, I love them. They're amazing. But I definitely recommend a trunk show, because you could be really surprised, and saving money is also super awesome. And the very, very last and most important thing of all is make sure that I don't care who says what about that dress. Make sure that you love that dress. Make sure you feel confident in that dress. Make sure you feel beautiful in that dress. And because it doesn't matter who wants what. I don't care what your fiancé wants you to wear. As long as you feel like you look beautiful, you will look beautiful. And he or she or whoever you are marrying is going to absolutely love it, because they love you and there's a reason they want to marry you. So just keep that in mind. And if you have confidence issues like me, just take people with you that you know love you and care about you and will be truthful with you and honest. And just remember that at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. You just want to feel wonderful, because this is a wonderful day in your life and you are marrying the person of your dreams and your soulmate. And that's all that really matters. So, with that being said, I think that is everything. Let me know in the comments what you guys want to see from me next. If you like this video or you thought it was helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you guys want to see some pictures of my wedding dresses that I tried on, I can definitely do that. And I think that's everything. So, I will see you guys on the flip side. Bye!